In this video, I'm going to test out some more common grab adhesives or construction adhesives. I actually have 8 or 9 different types this time, and I have actually tried some of these in the past, so there are other videos available showing some of these adhesives. This time, I've actually bought some adhesives which have been recommended by the viewers on YouTube. So some people have recommended the adhesives, I've gone out and bought them. We're going to test them, we're going to do 3 different tests. In the first test, we're going to stick some stainless steel box section to some sheet stainless steel and then measure the force required to separate the pieces using a hydraulic ram. In the second test, we're going to test the grabbing power by sticking some block pavers to a plasterboard partition. I must point out that some grab adhesives do recommend that anything stuck to such a surface should be propped until the adhesive has cured. If you're wondering why I do this test, it's because of a video that used this exact test but gave the biased results towards the manufacturers of the video. It is getting very expensive now doing all these tests, and there is quite a lot of work involved in setting them up. So this will probably be the last test for a while. All the stainless steel test pieces have had a label attached. I'm then going to put the corresponding grab adhesive on the stainless steel and then glue that down. These have all been cleaned on the back using methylated spirit. And in each case, I'm going to try and put a similar amount on each piece of stainless. And I'm going to turn that over and then I'm going to glue that down in position. I've actually got halfway down the tube now and there's nothing come out of that. Well, I'm afraid that one's a fail. Can't actually get that out. It's gone to about there, and then we can't actually get any of the product out. I have actually pierced it with a screw in the end there, but it just won't come out. This is the PL Premium. I actually had to transfer this into a regular sized silicone tube, as the tube that it came in was huge. I'm now going to speed things up a little. For some reason that's not coming out very well. Try it again. It works that well, it's obviously glued the end into the cartridge. In fact, we have got a little bit coming out of the end there. So as you can see, the product is still soft, but we can't actually get it to come out of the tube. Obviously, it's a bit disappointing that the Tech 7 never worked. We couldn't even get that out of the tube because that was £15. This one was a lot cheaper. This was about £3, but I can actually feel that that one is completely solid. I suppose that is one of the disadvantages of putting it in a cardboard tube. So we can definitely write that one off. I'm going to try and get some of the Tech 7 out of here, and I'm going to actually put it in a new cartridge. That way we can test it out. At least then we've not wasted the £15. These blocks have had well over 2 weeks for the adhesive to cure. I'm going to start off with the Gorilla Grab Adhesive. I'm then going to push that onto the board. I'm giving it a really good push and with a slight twisting motion. I'll now try the HB42. Now the PL Premium. Now the new improved Adiseal. And at last we have one that's not actually slid right off just yet. And I'll just apply the next one, which is PU18. Now the Supabond. And then finally, I'm going to try the Saves Nails. So the only two adhesives that actually stuck out of that test were the Supabond, which has done really well. That's only slipped a small amount, and the Adiseal. The Adiseal has slipped considerably, but it is still stuck to the wall. We'll now do the grab test with the Tech 7. Obviously that has slipped down considerably, but it has still stuck it to the wall. I've now glued these blocks of hardwood onto this stainless steel. This is 316 stainless. I did actually put all these on at the same time, and then I did actually have to move it out of the way. So the Saves Nails has actually creeped a bit backwards, so that has actually slid back. None of the others actually moved, but for some reason that one has moved. These blocks have had well over 2 weeks for the adhesive to cure. That one has finally failed, and we do have a bit of an hydraulic leak on there now. We've used that much pressure. Well, I think we can quite safely say that that one is firmly stuck. And I do have hydraulic fluid leaking all over the place here.
So as you can see, the Adiseal is quite firmly stuck to that stainless steel. The stainless steel is actually screwed down to the timber, and it's actually started to rip the screws out of the timber. So there was no way at all that that was actually going to budge. So that is stuck extremely well. That is actually unbelievable. I'm now going to test out the final one, which is Tech 7. Hopefully the hydraulics will hold up enough just to do that, because it does look like the seals are now passing in the cylinder. So there we have that test. I think the clear winner there was definitely Adiseal. So we've done a few different tests there. There's no overall winner, but there is a vast difference in the price of these products. Hopefully this has helped you to choose one of the better ones, which is not necessarily always the most expensive. I will put all the results in the description. I do hope you've enjoyed watching this video. If you have and you haven't done so already, please subscribe to the channel.